That Jesus died by crucifixion is one of the most certain facts of the ancient world. We have it attested by non-Christian sources like Josephus, Tacitus, Lucian, Marabar Serapion. They all attest to Jesus' execution, some being more specific about it being crucifixion. We have it attested in multiple independent Christian sources. We have it in the letters of Paul. We have it in the Gospel of Mark. Well, we have it in all four Gospels, including the Gospel of John, which is certainly independent of Mark. So multiple independent sources, non-Christian sources. The chances of surviving crucifixion were very small. There is only one account in antiquity of a person who survived crucifixion. The Jewish historian Josephus reports that at the time of the fall of Jerusalem, he witnessed three of his friends being crucified. So he went to his friend, the Roman commander Titus, and asked that he do him a favor and spare the lives of his three friends. And out of friendship, Titus ordered that all three be removed from their crosses and provided the best medical care Rome had to offer at that time. In spite of this, two of the three still died. So even if Jesus had been removed prematurely and medically assisted, his chances of survival were very small. However, there is no evidence that Jesus was removed or provided any medical care whatsoever, much less Rome's best. Now, of course, we can consider possibilities that Jesus somehow, maybe there's a possibility that Jesus survived his crucifixion. And you can entertain that by writing a blog on the internet. But historians must go with probabilities. So given all the evidence we have for Jesus' death by crucifixion, without any evidence, at least any decent evidence to the contrary, the historian at least must conclude that Jesus was crucified and the process killed him.